Hey, horsey people. That's a good little footage of some wild horses. This guy filmed them out here, and I'm thinking this guy, either this guy or this guy's a stallion. This guy's pawing on something back here, digging something up. I think he might be the stallion. And we'll see him in a minute here. I mean, the guy who made the video put some music. I don't want to steal his music because I'm going to try and explain some horse behavior. So the horses are moving off here, no problem. Everything's okay. He's filming. They're aware of him. We got babies. This is the stallion right here. And I don't know if that same horse I pointed to earlier. But you can tell by the white on the face. And he's looking over the herd. He's out to the side looking for dangers. He sees the babies there in the middle. Here's a couple little babies. I don't know if they're all his. If there's a couple stallions. Okay. This guy's a stallion. If this is the same horse that's a stallion, this horse, this guy came within 8 feet before stopping. If it's not the stallion, then it was probably curious. If he is the stallion, and a stallion horse starts walking up to you like that, face forward, man, that you need to back up and give some room. This horse is putting pressure, and if it's not the stallion, the horse is curious, so he's going to walk up and see if he can pressure you and push you away. And if you don't, because he's not the stallion, he'll say, you know what, I don't want to push it, I'll leave. But if he's a stallion and he comes up and he wants to put pressure to make you leave because he thinks you're too close to his herd and you don't leave, then he's going to put more pressure on you with either a strike, a kick, or a bite. So if this is a stallion, he's lucky it stopped at 8 feet. It looks a little young in the face, so maybe it isn't the stallion. You'll see the stallion in a minute here, and I'm not sure if it's the same guy. I think it is, because he's got that stripe, almost a bald face, snip, stripe, star, whatever they call it, and all the different markings that everybody wants to get. He's got a white line down his face. But I think he's the stallion, but it's hard to tell. So this little guy over here is learning how to eat and get poked with sticks. There's probably stickers in there. He's finding some food in the middle. Good natural horse behavior. He's learning. They're going to start playing. This little guy right here rears up. See him kind of like. So now they're going to chase. All this is good. People who want to have babies and they want to lock them up. And we got to imprint them. And we can't let them out because the other horses will hurt them. And they may run and trip because they can't walk real good. And we got to protect. Man, these horses are learning and growing and develop muscle coordination. So if something does chase them, if a coyote gets at them, they're going to know how to use their legs. You want a horse to be out in the open and be able to. So right here we have some good clacking behavior. Very dominant. This is the stallion right here. So he walked up to the stallion. Stallion put his ears back, but I wouldn't say they're like pinned back. They're back a little bit, but not necessarily pinned back like I'm warning you. They're just kind of like, eh, let me get my ears back. This guy's kind of irritating me, but I'll let him get close. So the little guy right here kind of clacks, walks up to probably dad, does some good clacking behavior, clacking of the teeth, shows submissiveness, saying I'm young, I don't want to get hurt. Buddy clacked probably till he was almost 3 years old. He was still clacked up because he was around with nothing but a bunch of mares, and they used to always beat his butt. I don't think he clacked to Mr. T too much because Mr. T never really corrected him. Mr. T just kind of moved in and put pressure on him, moved him by his size instead of by meanness. Like a lot of people in the horse world think you got to be a pain in the ass and a whip and scream and yell and show him who's boss. That's not true, and Mr. T never did that. That's not his style. He just kind of encroaches and won't back away and kind of impedes in your space until you do what he wants. So this little guy walks up. He's clacking his teeth saying, hey, I want to come up and say hi, don't hurt me. And the stallion kind of bends his ears a little bit, and the little guy catches the message and says, okay, I'll leave. But he doesn't leave without attitude. He's being cocky. He jumps up. He rears. I think he throws a little buck here. Trying to show his strength. Trying to show off for dad. Look how fast I am. Look how I can buck. Look at me. I'm going to be a big, tough horse one day. Yeah. Go out and play. So little guy runs around. And again, a stallion, looking at the camera. Man, if I was filming this, I would be like, oh, shit. I don't know if y'all saw that little bit because I was kind of off center here. Let me make sure y'all got that little bucking and his little kick and his little runoff. But anyway, these ears right here looking at you, this is a clue. You might not want to catch this. So he doesn't have the white face. I think he's a stallion. He doesn't have a white face. Obviously, I think he's a stallion because he's dropping. Normally, there's one stallion in the herd. Maybe there's a couple stallions. I'm not sure. But this guy, when this horse looks at you, man, you got to pay attention. I would have probably backed away if I was watching a wild herd and a stallion looked at me like that. I'd say, look, that's enough of a warning for me. I'm going to give you some distance. I'm going to release any pressure I'm doing, and I'm going to back away a few feet so you feel more comfortable. This horse is kind of saying, hey, dude, I see you, I'm aware, and I'm not real sure about you. If he was like the other horses ignoring you, you'd be okay. But when a horse acknowledges you, you need to pay attention on why he's acknowledging you. So this guy's kind of, you know, he's still a little, I'm not too sure about this camera, dude. So he's dropping a little bit. That could be a little bit of show that, hey, I'm the stallion here. Little babies out running around having a blast. Little babies are playing. Really cute little behavior here. But that stallion right there, man, is definitely keep an eye on that camera, dude. You notice all the other horses, except the young little kids who are running, are behind the stallion from the cameraman. Nobody's getting in front of the stallion and the cameraman because the stallion is like, if I got to go over there and attack you, see all the other horses? There's a barrier. The stallion has a barrier between any threat or danger. And that's another clue that the stallion sees this camera video guy has some sort of threat or unknown, and I'm not real comfortable with it. So he's keeping the herd and keeping himself as a buffer, because if this cameraman decides to run up and try to pet one of these horses, this stallion's going to be on him like white on rice. It's going to be go time. So there's no way this stallion's going to let something that he's unsure of get close enough to where he can get to one of his horses without him intervening first. Smart stallion. I mean, horses are really good at surviving and running a herd. I know somebody's going to be here, Rick, the stallion doesn't run the herd. It's the mare. Shut up with that stupid PC crap, believing what you're learning in these damn ignorant colleges. All right, so stallion decides, again, he's still keeping that buffer. He's still between. Babies are playing oblivious. You know, they don't have a clue on any threat at all. They're being kids. And so they're playing, but you know what? They ain't playing in front of the stallion too close to the camera. They're kicking and doing all their horseplay. And again, Barn Witches will be out here putting up signs. You shouldn't let horses play because they may kick each other and break a leg. And if they bite, they could ruin their skin and it'll leave a mark. And then you can't get a pink ribbon. Oh, man, you freaking show people in horse world just drives me nuts with the idiots. So good horse footage. that little guy's got all kind of energy. Very cute. Prancing. Strong, getting rid of some of that energy. And mom likes this. You know, all these breeders want to keep these babies locked up with mom. Man, moms need a break. This energy and stuff, this kid's going to come back and he's going to eat softer. He's going to want to sleep more. He's not going to be pestering mom to play with him. He's not going to be up mom's butt 24/7 being a pain in the butt. This is how horses are supposed to be raised, and you got these idiots wanting to lock them up and protect them and keep everything away from them and don't move and don't talk and nobody, and I got to tie it up so I can desensitize it, and I got to lay it down. I got to show it what a whip is, and I got to go out there and chase it with a plastic bag. And man, the lack of common sense. And you got something out of that, and we'll end that there. Again, this is used under Fair Use Act, education and critique.